What's going on, everybody? It's Robert and Aaron coming to you from the Old Bird Farm. Now, we're about to try something that a lot of you guys have been asking for. It's going to be orange tractor.
Those were my pants. Thank you very much.
It's going to be orange tractor and box blade with rippers versus wisteria. So, hey, I forgot about that. Come back here. Forgot Blue's love for chasing all things tractor. Blue, don't do that.
It's about to get real.
Coming off the top of the ground, the stuff that's already been ripped up or cut. So we still got to get down to the actual rooted end wisteria like we did a minute ago over there. something that you guys really haven't seen yet is the brush pile from clearing out over there. And I mean, there's some larger stuff like that in there, but for the most part, this is all just hysteria. So is this where it all started, right here?
That looks like the mother vine.
It does.
I'll tell you what, I wish that was a ginseng root.
Right?
We'd have some money.
Look at that. Yeah, I think that is the mother vine right there. That is crazy. Oh man, it looks like a horrible monster.
I know, yeah, it does. It looks like something like Sigourney Weaver would be fighting.
Right?
Look at it all. I mean, that's...
Make sure we burn every inch of that.
We need to go get a flame, like a, I don't know, like a plasma flamethrower or something.
Right?
Incinerate that crap.
Dude, look at this. This is, oh man, it's like a, it smells like a freshly plowed field out here for one, which is very nice, but also it looks like a yard kind of, sort of, again, it looks like it can be a yard again. Hey, you talked about this before too, something, planting some winter rye out here would probably be good, especially
throw some ryegrass on it. Yep.
Now that it's all turned up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, about that time, throw some ryegrass and that'll help keep it from eroding or anything.
Yeah.
Help keep it from being too awful muddy. And then we can turn it over. So I think we've got enough of these roots up now, plus we still need to get in there.
Yeah.
So I think all this, because the tractor's having a little bit of trouble picking that up, I think what we'll do is we'll just take and finish scraping everything over in the middle.
Right.
Because we know they're not there, we'll just burn that right here in the center.
Yeah.
And it also keep us from having to take all this over, because we can like put a fire right there and then just start bringing it over, you know, a little bit of time and burning it instead of having to truck it all the way over to that already massive bird farmhouse size pile of wisteria vines.
We need to go over there. Wisteria vines.
And
yeah, that sounds good.
Plus, if we ever want to do a garden or something here, it'll be good to burn right here in the center and scatter it and then plow that in. That's just going to, I mean, this is already really good soil, but put a little ash in it.
For sure.
And yeah, probably about two or three weeks, throw some ryegrass on it. And well, these chickens, and they don't come over here too much, so they shouldn't bother it too bad. Until they see you throwing it down on the ground and then they'll be over here. But yeah, the difference from a couple days ago is just pretty crazy.
Right?
The difference is raking all that, raking it up to where, you know, it was a minefield, hard to walk.
And yeah.
Just showing some of the dirt and just getting it scraped up. I mean, that's...
And the orange tractor did a darn good job of popping it up.
She was... It tested, you know.
It was working. It was working it. That's for sure. That's terrible.
Yes. Yeah, I think I'll get all this scraped up right here in the middle, and we'll get ready to go have a beer and call it a day.
Sounds good.